While everyone wonders where Hurricane Irene will head next, this is what it's doing right now. 100 mile an hour winds, heavy rain and storm surges continue to batter the Caribbean, the Bahamas the latest, heading northwest and gathering strength all the while. Still in its path, the east coast of the United States. Forecasters say it will clip North Carolina on Saturday, and they're not taking any chances. Tourist resorts evacuated, residents preparing for the worst.
I'm here by myself and it's just scary.
If it brushes past the Carolinas, Irene could make a direct hit on the Northeast.
Thank you.
And cities like New York, even with weakening winds, it would be damaging.
We hope for the best, but we prepare for the worst. And that's why this city is, I think, ready for this weekend.
At Martha's Vineyard, where the president's on holiday, they know they're also in Irene's path.
There's a time for them to go get supplies now. It's time to secure your boat with what you have.
It's expected to be the first hurricane to make landfall on the mainland for 3 years, and emergency planners are worried people may have become complacent.
What we would encourage people to do is to not just listen to the instructions and advice and orders that are given by local, state and local officials, but to actually follow those instructions.
It is big. I'll zoom back out. You can get an idea. We're actually flying over some of the outer bands right now, I believe.
From the International Space Station, the scale of Irene is evident. The U.S. has endured a year of extreme weather that's cost so far $32 billion. They are preparing again, stocking up and waiting and hoping they're ready. Greg Milam, Sky News, Washington.